Simona Fuller, Biomed X. Towards the rational design of selective kinase inhibitors by novel in silico methods.
So I would like to use this chance to give you an impression how we can use our proprietary bioinformatics tools to guide the design of selective compounds. Let's get quickly into the topic. Next slide, please. You are probably all aware that kinases are established drug targets. Reasons are that, for example, mutations and abnormal expressions of kinases cause many diseases. That's especially true for cancer, but also for other diseases such as inflammation and Alzheimer's. And the reasons why at least I believe that they will remain one of the major drug targets in the next years are shown on this and the next slide. So what you can see here is a phylogeny tree of the human kinome. So actually, I want to have the slide before. And what is plotted, for example, on the left tree is a distribution of the kinases which have very often are mutated and are driver mutations in common human cancer. What you can see is that it's evenly distributed over the kinome tree. So the picture gets even more crowded if we have a look to the right tree, where kinases are plotted which have a correlated high expression and a poor survival rate in the clinics in at least one cancer type. So what you can see is that pretty much each kinase could be an interesting drug target and worth exploiting. However, actually quite a large number of kinases is unexplored. Yeah, so what you can see here now are the 30 kinases which are the key targets of the FDA-approved drugs. So the picture gets a little bit better if we now have a look to the kinases which are let's say exploited in academia by small molecules, but still half of the kinome is unexplored and could provide actually quite great chances for competition-free drug discovery processes. So when you are working on kinases, there's always one question, what you have to deal with, and that's the low selectivity, and that's even true for FDA-approved compounds, like shown on the slide. So what is color-coded here in green is the key target, but then also all the off-targets, which are also inhibited by these compounds, resulting into undesired side effects and also in failure in clinical trials. And that was also the motivation for my team to develop new computational methods which help designing or improving the selectivity of compounds. So what we are using together with our proprietary tools is this wealth of nowadays available structural information, profiling information, but also machine learning techniques like deep learning. And together this allows us to address the following questions. So what are the most likely off targets in the kinome, and how can selectivity profile be improved? So for example, by using a machine learning, we now have 200 really high quality prediction models, so color coded in green and yellow on the white kinome tree, evenly distributed, high quality, much better than what is published in the literature. And then for example, by mining the available crystal structure, we are able to identify the selectivity determining areas, so which means in which areas can you achieve selectivity and by which chemical property. So give me 10 more seconds. So this information is then fed into a machine learning method like neural networks, and that's what is allowing us is to design new compounds with improved properties. So what you should now remember from this talk is, if you are working on kinases or other targets with selectivity issues, you should get in touch with us, and thank you for your attention.